Simon van der Velde, and in this video I will try to explain the basic principles of an atmospheric re-entry. So by the end of ATV-5's mission, ATV-5 will re-enter to Earth's atmosphere, whereby it will break up and burn up during the re-entry. So in this video I will explain and even demonstrate why ATV-5 will break up during its re-entry. So first of all, let's have a close look at ATV-5 before the re-entry. So ATV-5 is docked to the ISS, it has saved orbital velocity and altitude. For the orbital velocity we have 7.8 kilometers per second, and for the altitude we find 420 kilometers. So now if we calculate both kinetic and potential energy, we find one over two times ATV-5's mass times velocity squared. So we see here that the kinetic energy is tremendously high because of the velocity, which is squared for the kinetic energy. So for the potential energy, we find ATV-5's mass times a gravitational constant times ATV-5's altitude. So the potential energy is also quite high because of the high altitude. So if we add these two energies together, we find the total energy, or the orbital energy of ATV-5 before the re-entry, which is tremendously high because of the high kinetic energy due to the velocity which is squared, and because of the potential energy due to its altitude. So during the re-entry, both kinetic and potential energy will decrease because of the decrease in velocity and decrease in altitude. So our total energy will decrease. But what has this to do with the generation of heat during the re-entry? Well, in physics there is a law, which is called the conservation of energy, which states that the total energy of a system is always constant. So energy cannot be lost. Energy is always converted from one type of energy into another type of energy. So here, the kinetic and potential energy will be converted into another type of energy, which is here heat. Thermal energy. So all this energy will be converted to thermal energy during its re-entry phase. So we have seen how this thermal energy is formed because of the conversion of kinetic and potential energy into thermal energy. But how is this heat actually produced? Well, for this we have to look at the aerodynamics of a re-entry body. So here I have actually a photograph of a blunt body at a hypersonic environment. And just in front of our blunt body we have a shockwave, and before the shockwave we have our hypersonic environment. Just behind the shockwave we have our subsonic region. So basically what happens inside the shockwave, the air is highly compressed. So we compress the air in a very short period of time because we are traveling at hypersonic speeds. And compressing the air in a very short period of time is called an adiabatic compression. So we compress the air very highly in a very short period of time. And to illustrate the production of heat during an adiabatic compression, I've prepared a small experiment. For the experiment, I've made a temperature sensing unit in my left hand, and here I have a small circuit which is amplifying my temperature measurement and driving an LED. Now I will demonstrate my small experiment. I have now connected my circuit to my battery. I will now demonstrate the electronic circuit. So if I heat up my sensor element, the LED goes up, and if I let it cool down, the LED goes back on. I've made here a small container, which I screw into my temperature sensing element. And now I have a small container with a valve, an old bicycle tube valve. Now I can increase the pressure inside this container with my bicycle pump. Now the bicycle pump is connected to my small container, which is connected to my circuit. So now if I pump air inside my container, I will adiabatic compress the air, the heat will increase and the LED should go up. As you see here, the LED goes off. Now the air is expanding back and the temperature drops again, so the LED goes on again. So once again, so now to recap, we've seen that the thermal energy is caused by the conversion of kinetic and potential energy into thermal energy, and we have seen that the heat is actually produced because of adiabatic compression, which I even demonstrated with my experiment. And this production of heat will eventually cause ATV-5 to break up during its re-entry. So thank you for watching my video.